Street photography.
And go.
So often when you're shooting street photography, you can shoot in the most random places. So I see this lady here with a pink eye, and I ask her,
excuse me, miss. I saw you get up. I love your pink eye. Oh. Do you mind if I get a few photos of you? Just pretend like I'm not here. So what are you up to today?
Nothing, just going home.
Are you a fashion designer?
I am. And a blogger.
And a blogger. Did you make your entire outfit?
My dress.
Oh, so what's the concept?
It's a modest, our line is a modest fashion line, So we make modest dresses and clothing.
Oh, did you make this piece here too?
No, it was sent to me. It's a hamsa.
It's a what?
It's a hamsa against evil energy.
Where is your family of origin from?
I'm Jewish, my parents are Persian.
Oh, yeah, because I'll just ask him because it sounded Arabic?
Okay, yeah.
Am I wrong?
Yeah, Persian, Iran.
Yeah, and I've been to Dubai a few times too.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, you have a good look. So what have you designed on you right now?
With my dress.
Oh, that's super, what's the back look like? Oh, that's super cute. I love that. Yeah, so we're just out on the streets today and doing some street photography.
Cool.
And so essentially what I'm trying to do is explain to people, it's like, oh, you know, when you see fashionable, cool people on the streets, like, don't be shy. Because, you know, I saw you from afar, and I was like, wow, she looks so amazing, all that pink. But I'm like, I'm a little nervous because, like,
I approach her. No.
So when I approached you, did I seem friendly and stuff like that?
You're so sweet.
Aww.
And we like it. We like compliments.
So if you have other street photographers in the streets who want to approach you,
yes,
or if they want to approach other fashionable people, what kind of tips or advice would you give them?
Just be like, the way you did it, just come up to me like, I love your outfit, can I shoot you, this, that. Just be honest, be friendly, and like, go with the flow.
Yeah.
I think people appreciate it.
Oh, wait, can I also get, this would be a cool shot, your hands.
I have like the phoniest hands. The like this?
Phone. Oh, that's cool, because you got the eyes here too.
Let's do that.
So one thing I like to do when I'm shooting photos, is just looking for the, you can fix the ring. One thing I always love too is, I think what makes a great photo or a great portrait is all the details. So I mean, I'm sure you know is that when you're creating photos and creating images, and then just play with your phone a little bit.
Here.
And then you could even do a low angle. Oh, this is cool. So it looks like, hold up the phone to your face, pretend like you're using it. So I like it that it almost looks like you have all these random eyes on top of your eyes.
Neat.
So it's just kind of stacked on top.
I think
with photography, it's kind of cool too, just kind of, here, I'll just show you the picture too.
Oh, wow.
So it's kind of like this surreal picture.
I love that.
Of these eyes on top of your face and stuff like that. Isn't that super cool?
I love it. Nice. I love that. Really,
so,
really cool.
How can people find you?
I'm on Instagram.
Okay, why don't you show me your grams. Pull it up.
Sorry.
Yeah, it's all good.
My phone. So this is my blog.
Rachel?
Rochelle, yeah.
Rochelle.
Rochelle.
Let's see, I'm gonna take a
photo. It's a little slow.
It's a little slow. Oh, I'll just take a picture of the
stuffs
here, and then I could send
go back
you a
to
photo
that
afterwards. Nice!
Yeah, and then,
oh, there it goes. Whoa, looking super glam there.
Nice. Yeah, but yeah, it's all fashion. Do you have a card?
The best thing is just open up the Googles.
Okay. Google.
Yep. Google Eric Kim, E-R-I-C.
E-R-I-C,
Space Kim. Yeah, Eric like Eric Cartman from South Park, Kim like kimchi, because I'm Korean.
Got it.
Yeah, so essentially I specialize in street photography, so.
Love it, maybe we can do something together.
Yeah, and then I'll send you an email with some of the pictures and stuff
like that.
Thank
you.
Yeah.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Bye, good luck with everything.
Okay.
Thank you.
Keep it rolling. So some basic takeaways from this little interaction we had. So whenever you find interesting people, don't be shy, just approach them. Even for myself, I've been shooting street photography for a long time. Sometimes it's easy to get self-conscious about approaching strangers, especially when you find them as interesting or beautiful and stuff like that. But what I would recommend is, as an assignment, only photograph people that make you feel afraid. Because whenever I feel nervous and I see somebody I find interesting, it's actually my enthusiasm for photographing them. It's really difficult in photography to find interesting people in street photography, but once you find people, you're never gonna see them again. So just push yourself outside your comfort zone, interact with them, and you saw the technique that I was doing was, I was using my LCD screen, and while I'm talking to my subjects, I'm also making photos of them. And you know, treat them like a human being, you know, chat with them, ask them open-ended questions, offer to show them the photos, the email the photos, and who knows, maybe I could send her an email of her photos, get her card, and I could do some collaborations with them. Let's do some more photos with Oscar. So this time I'll focus on you be the second man.
Still recording.
Roy? Okay, cool. So we just came here to downtown LA here with the homies. And one of the things to do in street photography is know that regardless of where you are, you can make interesting photos regardless of where you are. So even in a garage. And that's one of the best ways to think about street photography. The world is your oyster. There's so many opportunities. So I just chatted with the guy here who's parking the car. His name's Oscar. So let's bother him for some more photos. And also realize with street photography, sometimes you feel shy about wasting people's time, but honestly, most people are just bored. Shooting photos of them, it just makes their life a little more interesting. Oscar, ¿cómo estás? ¿Dónde estás? Oh, más fotos, por favor, okay? Yeah. Can I take some more photos of you?
Well, yeah.
Oh, I have to do some stuff?
I have to work now.
Oh, you have to work now? Yeah. Okay. Can I get one photo of you? Maybe take the newspaper and cover your face. So it'd be surreal, like putting it over your face.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh. Yeah. And then take it and put it over your face. Oh, like that. And then one over your face. Oh, that like that. And plus. So me getting close, working the scene from different angles, and then also one photo of you, just looking very serious, looking to the camera, and then look right here, really strong and serious. All right, thanks a lot, boss. Yeah.
Okay.
Más fuerte! Yeah! Oh! Yeah!
Fuerte!
Look like the guy from Narcos. You know that Netflix show? Oh yeah!
Narcos!
Oh yeah! But man! Alright! Alright! See you later, man! Alright, we'll see you in a bit. Right, just keep...
See you later, man!
See you later, man! Yeah!
You have an extra SD?
Alright. No. We can give you another one. Alright, so know that when you're coming in street photography, talk to the strangers like they're your friends, because the whole world is essentially your oyster. Don't treat it like, you know, everyone's out there trying to get you. What's up? Oh, this thing? Street photography too. Talk with people and interact with them and just essentially have fun with it. And to be honest, one of the most difficult things in street photography is to conquer your fears of approaching strangers. And trust me, all the time I'm super still self-conscious about shooting street photography. But if you find somebody with an interesting face, interesting story, even open up to them and tell them that you are nervous, saying, hey, you know, I find you interesting because of X, Y, and Z, but I'm sometimes afraid of talking to strangers, and then they'll say, oh, no, no problem, and then that's a good way for people to empathize with you.
All right,
cut. I don't care. Do you mind if I make one of these and pretend like you're not here?
Pretend
like
how do I know? What is it for, first of all?
We're just shooting some street photography.
For what? For yourself?
For myself. The concept is, you know, when you're out on the streets, you find really cool, interesting people. Mm-hmm. But sometimes you feel a little bit nervous to approach them because it's like, oh, you know, they look so cool and fashionable, but like, I kind of don't want to bother them. But at the same time, like, they look so glam and just like, my photography spirit just wants to like capture that presence.
All right.
Yeah. So how long has your hair been pink?
20 years.
20 years? Why pink?
Because one day I just wanted to do it, so I did it.
Oh. Do you work in fashion or art?
Yes, I'm a designer.
Oh, what kind of things do you design?
Jewelry and cosmetics.
So have you designed any of your stuffs here?
Yeah, I don't have anything. Oh, no, I took my earrings off earlier.
Oh.
So I'm upstairs designing. I'm right here.
Where were you?
In the building next to that one.
Oh, cool. Do you have a card?
I don't have a card on me. It's Tarina Tarantino.
Tarina Tarantino. Uh-huh. Oh,
like Quentin.
Like Quentin. Not related.
Not related?
Not related.
Well, I think you look more glam than him.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Well, yeah, so my name's Eric Kim. You can just Google me.
Okay.
Eric, like Eric Cartman from South Park. Kim, like kimchi, because I'm Korean.
Okay, got it.
Yeah.
Got it, Eric.
But
very good.
But just loving the light on you.
Thank
and
you. Well,
essentially what I'm trying to do, too.
Oh, you're making me feel famous.
Dude, come on, girl. Look at you. So essentially what I'm trying to do is getting your pink hair against the blue sky.
Yay, nice!
And then the light actually is coming from here, so do you mind if I get some photos here? Just looking towards the light?
Sure, why not?
Oh yeah, just think about a nice, beautiful day in downtown LA. Think about all the beautiful things you're going to design.
Yes, yes.
Think
you're
about
good.
Like all these weird people approaching you to take their photos and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
All right, cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Right, Broadway.
Get your Tom Ford on.
Yeah.
All right, keep rolling. All right, I'll just stand in front of you and then I can chat. All right. So just to basically recap what happened. When I'm shooting street photography, especially or street portraits or looking for color, just look for bold colors or things that interest you. And you can see when I first approached her, she was a little bit uncertain. She's like, I don't know what this guy is. He seems like maybe a little bit too pushy or aggressive. But honestly, I think radical transparency is actually the best way to go about it, which means you approach a stranger, you tell them that you're nervous, and you essentially use what I call tactful flattery to make better photos. The basic concept of tactful flattery is that you flatter people, you compliment them on their look, but you're tactful about it in the sense that you're being honest and you're actually being authentic. So for example, I would think it would not be tactful or wouldn't be authentic to say, oh, you're the most beautiful person in the whole entire world and blah, blah. Like, but rather saying something like, wow, pink is such a unique color. I've never seen the color pink on you. And also explain your process to the subject saying, hey, you got pink hair, there's a blue sky, there's a nice color combination. I said, oh, and I make assumption like, oh, are you a designer? Are you in fashion? And you keep it broad enough so people could connect the dots for you. And also one of the big tips too is if you want to make better street portraits, share the LCD screen with them and say why you wanted to make their photo. And then, you put people in a good mood, and while you're talking with them, keep shooting photos and remember to smile and compliment people.
Cut.
Sick. In my face, you hear my hands. Okay, that's good. And then I look fancy with my coffee cup. Right? So tell me when you're rolling. All right. So currently here at Il Cafe, one of my favorite coffee shops in downtown LA. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the different equipment you should use in street photography. So ultimately, it doesn't matter what you use in street photography. You could just shoot with your iPhone or your Android device. You could shoot with a more modern digital camera, like I have the Lumix G9 camera with the Leica 12mm 1.4 lens, which is roughly a 24mm full frame equivalent. And also I have here is the Leica MP film camera with a 35mm Summicron F2 lens. So ultimately with street photography, you just want to use the camera or the tool which is easiest for you to capture the decisive moment. The decisive moment in street photography is whenever you see something that you find personally meaningful, and then you just quickly bring up the camera, and you quickly click, and you make the photograph. So I want to give you a basic introduction to different technical settings for street photography. So first and foremost, assuming you're shooting with an iPhone or a digital camera or any sort of phone, I would actually just recommend using the default photo app and just clicking and taking photos. You could experiment shooting vertical photos, click, or you could hold it in your own side, and whenever you find interesting people, you can shoot with your phone. One of the big benefits of shooting street photography on a phone is that it's always with you, it's inconspicuous, and you actually look a little bit less creepy. So I would actually recommend, when you're starting off street photography, just practice shooting with your phone. And in terms of processing your photos, I would recommend VSCO, V-S-C-O, to process your photos. For color presets, I would actually recommend their Aesthetic A6 series. Now, another option is you can shoot with a more modern digital camera. So I have the Lumix G9 Pro. It's an example of what they call a Micro Four Thirds sensor. One of the big benefits of using a Micro Four Thirds sensor is that the sensor is smaller, but there's actually more depth of field. This camera, for example, I currently have the 12mm lens on it. That, with the crop sensor of the 2x form factor of the Micro Four Thirds body, means that it's effectively a 24mm full frame equivalent lens. The benefit of shooting with a wider angle lens, like a 28mm or 24mm or a 35mm lens, is that you'll get more depth of field and everything will be in focus. Generally, in terms of the technical settings, I'd recommend this. I'd recommend shooting either P mode, which stands for program mode, and essentially the camera will automatically choose your aperture and shutter speed. In P program mode, one of the benefits is that you could actually change your ISO. So you could shoot with a different ISO of, like, you can increase your ISO accordingly. I would actually recommend, if you're shooting street photography in P mode, keep your ISO at 1600, which will help you have a fast shutter speed, so none of your street photos will be blurry. Another option on different cameras, especially the Lumix bodies, there's something called IA mode, which stands for Intelligent Auto Mode, which the camera chooses your aperture, shutter speed, autofocus, and ISO. So essentially, you just point and click and you shoot street photography to capture the decisive moment. The most important thing to know in street photography is that don't worry so much about the technical settings, about making everything manual focus and manual everything. The most important thing is to capture the moment. Generally speaking, if you're shooting in P or program mode, I'd recommend you setting your autofocus point to the center and let the camera do most of the thinking in terms of the technical settings. And what you're going to focus on is to use the camera to frame, to compose, to interact with your subjects and shoot. Also with digital cameras, nowadays you have options. You could use the LCD screen to make photos. And the benefit of shooting with an LCD screen is that it allows your hand more flexibility to shoot with different angles and allows you to talk to your subjects while you're shooting them and still maintain eye contact. Also, I found the benefit of using a camera, like a digital camera, like this. You can put the camera super low to the ground and shoot from a low angle, or you could hold the camera up from a very high angle and shoot down. So there's lots of benefits for that. Now, we're gonna move on to talking about manual focusing lenses. So I currently have here a Leica Summicron 35mm f2 lens. And the thing that's very important to note is there's a focusing tab here on the bottom. So the basic concept to know is this. If you're shooting with a film camera or a Leica or a rangefinder, you want to learn how to focus by feel. So for example, if your finger is dead center, the pre-focusing range is here. It's 1.2 meters, aka 4 feet. And the important thing to know with 1.2 meters when your focus is dead center, that's roughly 2 arm lengths away. So if you're out shooting on the streets and you extend your arm and you visualize what two arm lengths looks like, you'll make sure everything's in focus. In terms of your aperture, which is also known as f-stop, which is how much of your scene is going to be in focus, I would actually recommend f8 and be there. F8 is the optimal aperture to use, which allows for maximum depth of field, but also lets in more light. You could also shoot at f16, which gives you even more depth of field, but the downside is you'll have to need more light and brighter situations to get everything well lit. I would recommend, generally speaking, f8 as a good technical setting. Now, what you're trying to do in street photography is you're trying to pre-focus and you're trying to capture the decisive moment without having to hold up your camera, fumble around with the focus, and shoot. So the way to do that is, by default, once again, keep your finger in the center notch. Keep it in the center, and if your camera is centered in the center, then the lens is 1.2 meters, which is about 2 arm lengths away. And the way to read this is this. You can see I could change my aperture. Let's say it's at f8. These little marks here on the bottom of the camera essentially show what's going to be in focus. So you can see this number 8 down here. It means that everything from about 1.5 meters all the way up to about 1 meter is going to be in focus. And as I take my finger and I rotate this more to the right side, I'm focusing on two subjects that are further away. So you can see now it's pre-focused to about 3 meters, which is roughly about 10 feet. And now, assuming I'm still at f8, everything from about 5 meters to about 2 meters will be in focus. That's the far distance. And so, once again, to recap, an easy way to think about this is with your finger in the center. That's medium distance, which is 1.2 meters away, which is about 2 arm lengths away. But if you take your finger and you rotate it 45 degrees to the right, that's a far distance, which is about 3 to 5 meters, which is roughly about 4 arm lengths away. So that's for your subjects far away. And the last thing to remember is if your finger is dead focused on the center, you rotate this a little bit to the left side. Now you're kind of focusing towards a close distance, which is roughly about 0.9 meters, which is about 1 arm length away. And you could see, unfortunately, the closer you focus at F8, you actually have less depth of field, which means about 0.7 meters to about 0.9 meters is going to be in focus. So essentially, all you have to know is when you're shooting street photography is this. Keep your aperture at F8, and when you're shooting street photography, keep your camera, keep your lens pre-focused at about F8, and when you're shooting street photography, don't feel like you need to nail the focus absolutely perfect. By shooting at F8, more of the scene will be in focus, and the most important thing is for you to hold up the camera, frame, and click. Alright. The slipper and just like giving him the smackdown. Yeah. So essentially, when it comes to dogs and stuff like that, I'm like, man, these are all ungrateful fuckers.
Yeah, man. That almost looks like a human bite.
Yeah.
Almost.
Nuh-uh. Kid bite.
Yeah, like, yeah. Yeah. That's what I assume.
It's just the top teeth.
Yeah. So, yeah, just I think just the top. Like, enough where it's like, it's a tiny dog and it breaks skin.
Right.
And it starts to bleed. And you're like, what? Like,
what's bruised, too?
Yeah. Right. Start recording? Mm-hmm. All right, so we chatted with my buddy Ryan. So let's see if he's down for me to take some photos of him. So first thing I'll just do is I'll just take some photos of him working. So it's kind of cool to know in street photography, you chat with people, you interact with them, and then once you're cool with them, you can just shoot all the candid photos you want and actually be a lot less self-conscious. And when you're shooting a scene, just be patient and work the scene and just be patient. And just keep clicking. So you can see, I'm trying to compose him where he's on the left side of the frame and having a little bit of negative space on the right side of the frame. And ideally, I'm just keep shooting him, just waiting for him to hopefully turn around, because it's always more interesting to have the subject's face than just the back of their head.
Jesus.
Yeah, Jesus Christ had dreads, so shake them.
What?
I don't got none, but I'm planning on growing some.
There are three cameras on me.
Imagine all the Hebrews going down.
I can't. hello everyone. Boy, like something I was never ready for.
Oh, do you look so cool?
I got
you and these dope lines, leading lines in the background.
Let me see.
Yeah, let me see.
Take some good shots.
Yeah. Yeah, check out the photos.
I was looking. I was like, oh, this is good.
Well, you know what?
You're just so.
Oh. Well, I call it the Asian tourist technique, where I just channel my inner mom. Ah, thank you.
Not even my nose or angles.
That's important.
Yeah. So
God,
one of the tips.
Upshotting me.
Oh, so what you could do? Oh, let's check this out.
Oh, there we go.
You could look at yourself. How's the angle look, Ryan?
It's black.
Oh, it's black?
Wait. Yeah. There we go.
That's racist. Okay, there it goes. Can you see yourself?
Yes, I can.
So how's the angle look?
There we go.
Oh, there it goes.
That I'm okay with, but I have to like.
That looks good. So what the tip is, oh, put your chin down. So lean towards the camera.
Yeah.
And what you do is stick out your neck like this. This is actually what
like
people do.
Yeah.
And then tilt your head downwards.
My friend shoots headshots and always says like,
oh.
Go out Mr. Burns style.
Oh, Mr. Burns style.
Get rid of all this.
Oh yeah. So action. One tip is using the LCD screen to look down to get those angles. And essentially, look into the future triumphantly. Chin up, like a boss. Now look down, look towards the camera. Mr. Burns. Sick! Dude, you're the man. Here, check out the photo. I like that. So essentially what I'm trying to do is trying to get the leading lines in the photo. So it's kind of nice that it matches your hair, and it's kind of like this kind of nice minimalist shot with all the lines here. This one is...
Oh, that's a blue mix.
Yeah. Are you into photography too?
I've done some.
You can check it out.
I see.
Yeah. So it's actually a new camera from Lumix. It's like Panasonic Lumix, and it's really good for doing 4K video and also for taking still photos. And it's insane because the autofocus is just so fast.
And look how close you get focused. Focus on my face. See how close you get.
That's really detailed. Jesus Christ. You don't want to get that close to me.
Well, make sure when you take your photo. Well, you know, I only put on a little concealer today, too.
Your skin looks better than mine. I haven't had any facials in a while.
Well, I call it the kimchi diet.
You'll see all of my... Oh, you're Korean.
Oh, yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is your mom or dad Korean?
My mother's from Daegu.
Oh, from Daegu.
Yeah, Daegu.
Dude, yeah. My family's from Busan.
She's also mixed with a little Japanese, but Korean. And then my dad is Dutch, Irish, English, Welsh, Native American, Indian.
So what are you up to today?
This is Chikara.
Oh, what's her name?
I take pictures of her.
Oh, what's her name?
She lives a Chikara.
Chikara.
Chikara, like the power, the stone.
Yeah.
Stone.
Ooh.
And she's a tripod. She only has three legs.
Oh, what happened to her third leg?
I adopted her that way.
Oh, wow. That's really amazing, actually.
Why don't
you guys get a low angle?
So what's the most rewarding thing about owning a dog?
Oh, she's my guardian angel. My companion.
Aww. And then what are you up to today?
No, you look good.
Why is she like totally covered up and then she's showing her little belly?
No, ooh, the belly's sexy.
Not
I like it. Yeah, so essentially what you're doing is whenever you find interesting people and you have a nice chat, you know, sometimes you want to chat with people, but you feel a little bit nervous or awkward, like, oh, I don't know how they're going to interact with me. But it's really nice that you're chatting with us and then find my photography. So I'm like, oh, she's probably pretty cool. So let's see if she'll be down.
I feel like every other friend of mine is a photographer.
Oh,
but different. They're all like, you know, either headshots, fashion, commercial, post stuff, everything.
Well, I'll do bar mitzvahs. I'll shoot han people in hanboks or whatever. It's all good.
Okay.
Why don't you put your hat here?
Okay.
And so, so I really like this.
And then we'll go.
So one of the things that I'll just explain for you too. So one of the things I think is the most important is when you're making photos, it's always about the background.
Yes. Yeah.
So I think it's something that a lot of street photographers and photography in general don't. Oh, it's okay. Go for it, brother. It's all good. No, you got the sexy beard.
Oh, thank
sexy
you.
Beard coming through.
Is the camera on?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, great. Wait, hold it.
Yeah.
You guys should come shop at my shop. I have a store on Melrose and in downtown.
Uh-huh.
Every Sunday, I'm on Melrose and Fairfax.
Yeah.
Miller's Room. And then downtown, we have a shop walking distance from the Ace Hotel.
Oh, yeah.
It's on 10th in Los Angeles.
Uh-huh.
And it's hot. It's for delicious people if you want to be delicious.
Is it lit?
It's lit.
Wait, did you make the shirt?
No, this is Harley Davidson, but I have a lot of reworked vintage clothes there.
Oh, yeah.
My jewelry,
yeah.
My Levi Coochie Cutters.
Oh, wait. Show the Coochie Cutters.
It's a Levi Coochie Cut.
Oh, that's sexy,
inspired
dude.
Inspired by St. Wes.
Oh, I like that.
Okay, how do I get this footage?
Thanks. So just Google me. My name's Eric Kim.
Hold on. Do you know these people?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
These crazy people.
These crazy people. Okay, how do I get this footage?
Just Google Eric Kim. It's probably the best.
And if you're taking a photo of me, this is the one.
Oh, yeah.
You got
the angles?
Get
the angles. Or just do the video. I'll do the video. Get the... Ooh, that's good. That's good. Pucker the lips some more. Ooh, yeah. So I like it. Do that again. So essentially what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get you, and I'm trying to get the reflection of you in the background. So it's kind of nice, not only you, but also getting our reflection.
Oh,
so
that's actually interesting.
It's kind of interesting is that you're kind of creating the different layers, and you can see here.
All right, Eric, I want these photos this evening.
Give me your email. I'll send them over to you. And then, what you do is crouch down towards me, look into the lens. Yep. And essentially, I'm getting you and these epic lights in the background.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Cool, man.
Spontaneous.
I'll give you my email.
Give me your email.
That's my phone's over there.
All right. You can just come to me. And
don't run from here.
All right. We won't run.
Yeah.
All right. So. All right. So.
Yeah, and then I'll give you my information.
All right. So MC2. All right. So one of the most important things is if you're approaching a stranger. And they're looking fashionable and glam. Can I mess up with the look? You have to find a nice background.
Okay.
So one thing I really like about these
definitely need a background because I'm not really
fashion.
No, you look good. You got the sexy belly.
This is the belly. I have the belly. Sexy belly.
The sexy belly. So all those downward up dogs, okay? So it's kind of fun that there's different ways of giving portraits. I could either make a portrait of you here and then you get the reflection.
That'd
here,
be cool.
Or just a simple gray background.
Okay.
So
you want to do both?
Yeah, we do both. So let's start against the simple gray background.
Okay.
And you wanted to get chakra into the shot too?
Should I hold her?
Hold her.
Okay.
All right. So this is kind of a new fun technique. Is I just pull out this swivel screen to get a sense of what you look like too. Because I think it's kind of cool to be empowered to know what exactly it looks like. So essentially, what I'm trying to do is get you in chakra, and trying to capture this kind of love that you have for one another. And also, why don't you poke up your eyes? Because I'm sure you have nice eyes. And you can just poke it up. Oh yeah.
No,
you look good. Ooh, fierce. Okay, that's good. And then, let's see, how can you... Oh, so this is also one thing too. Why don't you just whip around your hair a few times while you're taking the photo?
With Chikara.
Just whip Chikara and your hair around. Oh, that's fun. So I'm just taking a bunch of photos. I don't know which one is gonna be good.
I'm looking like a crazy woman.
Yeah, so you can see, just whip your hair around. I whip my hair back and forth. Cool. All
right. That actually look really cool.
Okay. Yeah. And then so now what we could do is we could practice shooting some here in the mirror too. Okay. Maybe step a little closer to me here. So essentially what I'm trying to do with the composition is get you...
Wild woman with the dog.
Wild woman with the dog?
My dad would love these.
Oh yeah. You'll definitely get the shots. So essentially when I'm shooting the photos, I'm trying to create these surreal images of you, Chakra?
Chikara. Chikara, like the Japanese
stuff. Oh, Chikara, okay.
Chikara.
And I'm trying to get these different layers in the photographs. And get really close to the mirror, like you're looking at yourself. Ooh, so that's kind of surreal. So if you look back at the photo, look at the camera. That's kind of cool, huh? Yeah. That is super cool. And whip your hair a few times again.
Like how? Which direction?
Any direction.
Right,
what feeling does it? What spirit do you have? Oh yeah. Cool. Ooh. Yeah.
I don't
want to
break up this party. I just have to.
Oh yeah. For sure. Dude, he's already on it. Okay?
Oh yeah.
So yeah, so you can see, you never know when you're gonna get a nice moment. Yeah, these are fun, huh?
I like that one.
Yeah. Wait. So MC, can I get your email?
Yeah. Well, okay. Yeah. It's feeling rocky. All
right. Oh, okay, let's...
But you probably should only gotta post the cool-looking
shot. Oh, yeah, for sure. Sorry, can you get one of you guys' iPhones?
I think Drake. I think
I'm not even gay.
No, me neither. I think you're mistaken for Drake a lot.
For Drizzy?
Drizzy a lot.
I consider myself the Asian Kanye.
That's
it. Think of those turbo thoughts, man. See these?
What are those, babe?
I like those.
You know what's funny? They look like babe. Oh, thanks, man. My wife made it.
You should probably just shoot one. It's not sanitary to have
that. They're
chic. Yeah. No, it's our friends made it out in Saigon. You can take a look. This is a prototype.
This would be really cute for your party on Sunday.
Yeah. Where's my camera?
It's a purse. It's a purse for you.
It's not a purse.
It's a purse for you.
No, that's good. No, it's
Can I see?
Take a look. Ooh, you might get some shots of you too.
I'm like,
you got Black Panther on, man.
Mikey's. This is giving like auntie verse, right?
You gotta give me my things together.
Oh yeah. Well, do that. Put your hands over your face, kind of that surreal look. Both hands.
I want one. Who made it?
And then do like the side like
this.
My wife. I give my email. You could put your hands over the face. Closer to your face. Closer to your face.
My nose ain't that much.
He's nail polish.
Look. So I can see your eyes. Oh, that's good. Both eyes. Nice. So what are you guys up to today?
Chilling. I'm just kidding.
Yep. Just kidding.
Oh, is that you?
No, that's David.
That's beautiful right there.
Okay, so what's your
email? But
you didn't care about anything that you asked.
So it's the name of our company is called Haptic Industries. H-A-P.
H-A-P.
Yeah,
I'll do it.
Haptic.
So, Haptic. It did sound like you said half dick.
Yeah,
it did sound like you said
half dick.
Yeah. I'm like,
I'm Asian,
thing.
I'm half dick, you know?
Right.
Oh, okay. I wish I was black.
Yeah, it is pretty big down there.
Yeah.
Is it?
Real talk.
Just saying.
Okay. Is it burdensome?
No, I love it.
No.
It's big and delicious.
Oh, I love it. I love it. Okay. So
at some point, it's okay. A lie. But I mean,
it's because.
Yeah, what was your name again, boss?
My name's Marquise Miller.
How do you spell that?
M-A-R.
Uh-huh.
Miller.
I-S-E. But all my friends call me Miller.
Miller.
Come on, Juicy.
All right. So what's your concept, Marquise?
I do like rework vintage clothes, whatever the hell I like, basically. Whatever I like, that's what I sell.
Do you got photos of your,
yeah,
your stuff?
I do. So this is my shop right here on Instagram. Yeah. I don't really take too many photos because, yeah, I don't want anybody trying to steal my content, yeah, but content. They're all one-offs and,
oh,
amazing, delicious garments.
I love it.
I have, so it's a lot Miller's
of,
room?
Yeah. I sell to a lot of brands. Tom Ford, oh, Top Shop, Hadi Slimane.
Damn, dude.
Yeah.
Kanye better watch out. Oh, so I have a curious question. Have you heard the controversy with Kanye and the whole slavery thing?
Yeah.
What's your guys' take on that?
I don't have a take on it. I'm not speaking. Kanye is Kanye, and I respect him, and maybe he made a bad choice.
Yeah, we love Kanye.
I love him.
And Kanye's a Gemini, like himself.
Oh! Ultimate Gemini.
And he's delicious. When's your
birthday? You survived past 25?
Yeah.
My birthday is January 31st.
You are a...
Pisces.
I think I'm...
Aquarius.
Aquarius.
Oh, yeah. What are you?
I'm a Virgo.
Virgo?
Yeah.
Oh.
So, Beyonce.
Yeah. Huh?
Beyonce.
Michael Jackson.
Pusha T.
Stevie
Wonder. No, Pusha T and Stevie Wonder were born, yeah, on my birthday.
Pusha T?
Yeah, we have the same birthday, May 13th.
Oh, what?
Yeah, that's why he's like a lyric genius and he's everything. And I'm him and Stevie Wonder and myself are all born the same day. We're all geniuses.
Oh. What do you think about Big Mensa?
I think he's pretty delicious.
Vic's pretty sick, right?
Yeah.
You kind of look like Vic, actually.
Uh-oh.
Look a little like Vic, too.
I'll take that.
And let me guess, he looks like Pusha T, right?
Huh? Oh, he kind of looks like Pusha.
No,
I was
ASAP. Yeah.
I was cool with
ASAP.
No,
you're cool with ASAP?
Yeah.
All right, ASAP Rocky. ASAP goes harder.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you mind if I get a shot of you too, boss?
Sure.
You must get a shot of
Let's see. Oh, can I get you in the corridor?
In the corridor.
Go in the corridor, man. And what's your name, man?
I'm Mikey.
Mikey?
Yes,
Mikey Rocks?
Mikey Rocks.
Mikey Rocks, baby. So, Mikey, what's your passion in life?
I am a fashion designer.
Oh, you're a fashion designer.
Yeah.
Why do you love fashion?
Because it's my life.
Mm-hmm.
It's been my life.
What's your personal philosophy about fashion?
One more time.
What's your personal philosophy about fashion? Like, why is fashion important? Because you know there's some people that are like, oh, fashion is like superficial and it's like whatever. So what's your take on it, Mikey?
Fashion is pretty much just what you make it. I feel like it's you, and if it's not you, then you're just doing it for no reason, pretty much. And I feel like that's where it comes from. It's supposed to come from you. You know what I mean? So, like you with your camera, you like it because you like it, right?
Yep.
So if I was to just take your camera and take some pictures, I'm just going to take them because that's, you know what I mean? I'm not going to be really into it. That's more you. Me making clothes, I'm going to be more, you know what I mean? Like vice versa. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. No, I love it. You got a really clean. Oh, I love the suede blue.
The suede blues. Man.
Suede blues. So one thing I even like to do when I'm taking photos, cool thing with these cameras, I can put my LCD screen on the bottom. Yeah. That's sick. So why?
What kind of camera is that?
So this is a Lumix G9.
Dope.
It's really dope for doing 4K video and stuff like that.
Nice.
Are those Air Forces?
They are.
Can you see the side?
Yeah.
Oh, that's sick. Yeah, because I got some Air Force fly knits.
Dope. So where are you gonna put the pictures? Where's the content at?
Yeah, so I'm just like, essentially just making a video of just like me essentially talking to strangers and stuff like that. So I think it's the thing too, is like when I see fashionable people,
right,
or people who I think they have a good look,
right,
you ever get like you want to chat with them, but sometimes you feel a little bit like self-conscious, you're like, oh, I don't want to come off as being like,
right, just random.
Yeah, like random, yeah, and stuff like that. So yeah, no, I saw you look good, you got good skin.
Thank you.
Just like ASAP. Wait, and then can I get some shots of you against the mirror?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, that's kind of cool, just a shot from the back of the head. And who are some of your biggest fashion designer inspirations?
People like Alexander McQueen, Virgil.
McQueen?
Yeah, Virgil's dope.
Virgil?
Yeah, of course.
What do you think about the whole Louis Vuitton thing?
I think it's dope. I like it.
Let's see. Oh, it'll be cool. Come here and look down towards me, and then I'll try to get these catch lights. So just like chest forward, just looking down straight into the lens.
Oh, that's pretty dope.
So just to see what it looks like. That's pretty dope, huh?
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
And work the scene. Essentially, when I'm shooting it, I'm trying to fill the frame with all these catchlights in the background like that.
Right, yeah.
That's pretty dope, right?
Yeah, that is dope. I want these.
Oh yeah, for sure, I'll send them to you, man. No, like, because I'm really passionate about fashion too, but sometimes like I'm just like kind of self-conscious. But you got a good look, man.
For sure,
like,
thank you.
Wait, we go over there and let me get your email too.
For sure.
Oh, it's all good.
Yeah.
Man, I came up on the come up today, man.
Yeah, all right, well, I would like you to email me that contact.
Yeah, Black all Magic, right. Baby. All right, let me get iPhone. Where's the iPhone?
Damn, you're fine, babe. Can they give me a second?
Now can I get a minute?
He ain't got no bra.
Oh yeah.
He
ain't got
no bra.
Why did he give him a ducklet?
Huh?
Why did you do
dude, that? That's my Kim K look, dude.
He ain't got no bra.
Yeah,
he
Kim
so
K look, dude.
Come on, haircut.
I know he's.
Your skin is looking
Mike,
jazzy.
Mike K-U-Y.
Yeah, you can just.
Your eyebrows is alright.
No, are you double fisting the FaceTime?
We've been down here for a minute. We was doing some shopping for me for my birthday. You coming out?
When is it?
Well, my birthday's next week, Wednesday, but I'm gonna give a raid set on Sunday. So come, don't work. Just come and drink a little bit.
Don't work.
Call out. Call in sick.
Sick.
Send them to me.
Yeah.
Is this, it's your
and
brand?
Then,
yep.
Come fuck
ask
with
Hunter
it.
LA. Sick, man.
You said who?
Dude.
Yeah, he gonna wear some little
good man.
Some booty shorts.
Sure. And
I'm not wearing any booty shorts, but I'm gonna come.
Yep.
It's gonna be really great though. We're gonna bring a lot of our friends up upstairs and have a good time.
Okay.
I'm getting my hair twisted, so don't worry about it. I'm out here looking
I look pretty crazy.
I'm looking
Okay, so one of the tips I have when you're shooting street photography is if you're shooting candid photos, look for a nice patch of light. So right now, the sun's kind of setting. You see this epic shade here of light. So essentially what I'm trying to do now is the fishing technique. You take your camera and you set your camera to minus one exposure compensation. Uh-huh. And the benefit of shooting at minus one, or even sometimes minus two exposure compensation, is it totally blacks out the background and the subjects coming to the photos are very well lit. And especially if you want to create a dramatic photograph, like shooting more cinema type photography, essentially this is like what Fan Ho did a lot of his photos, that, and also what photographers like Alex Webb do. And the big tip is do this when you're shooting at golden hour. That's usually sunrise or sunset. You know the light's good when the shadows of you are actually taller than you in real life. So for example, what we're trying to do, so I'll walk over here, is I'll try to make a nice composition and just wait for subjects to come into the frame. And when I'm shooting them, I try to get the legs split like a V. So let's just kind of walk it. So for example, now I'm a lot closer and you can see all these nice photos of people as they're walking into the scene, how they're so well lit. And these, especially when you're shooting.
I think my ND filter is
not working.
Not allowing me to see your the image on your screen.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's good. All right. Record me? All right. So generally when you're shooting street photography, what you're trying to do?
Oh, he has a better angle. Right?
Okay.
Yeah.
So essentially what you're trying to do in street photography is, now you see the light is up there coming towards me, and what I'm doing with my camera is I'm setting it to about minus two to minus one exposure compensation. And as people are walking towards me in the light, I'm trying to make nice dramatic photos. So what you try to do is look for nice light and background. So for example, you have this nice pathway here and you have people in the background walking towards you. So effectively what I might do is I might try to set up a composition. So I see this nice angle here, this public parking sign, and there's an arrow there. So I'll just hold on my camera there and I'll essentially wait for somebody to enter my frame. So So,
take a step back.
So you could just start rolling.
Yep.
Are you rolling?
I've been
rolling. Okay. So, essentially here, this is the fishing technique. Is I found a nice composition, and I'm just patient until somebody walks into the frame. So I see this lady in the background, the pink, about to enter the frame. And I'll just start taking photos as they're coming in. And you see this nice lady in the pink? I'll do this, I'll walk towards them and shoot while walking.
Yeah. Really attuned
to
eye.
So essentially what I did in that technique was, when you see a couple walking towards you, you could actually walk in between them and hold your camera up and start shooting. And this will allow you to make photos of them shooting head on. Okay, so one of the things to know when you're shooting street portraits is this. Everyone is actually wanting to be photographed, especially people who are fashionable, especially if you're in LA, downtown areas. When you see people with interesting looks and different outfits, they want to be photographed. They want people to compliment them. They want you to interact with them. And whenever you feel nervous to approach strangers, channel that fear in a positive way to chat with them and create a new story and create a dialogue with them and also take photos. Rolling?
Yeah.
Love this guy here. Excuse me, sir. I love your outfit. Do you mind if I take some photos of you?
Sure.
Yeah. So, do you work here?
Downtown, yeah.
Oh, so what are you up to today?
Going to eat at the restaurant right next door.
Ooh, so I love your mustache. Can you get some photos of you just like stroking your beautiful mustache?
You guys are funny.
Yeah. So, what kind of work do you do?
I'm an apartment manager.
Dude, I thought you're in the industry.
I wish I was. No. Yeah, no, nothing with that.
Can I also get one photo of you just looking up towards the light? Ooh, that's really beautiful light there. And then stroking your mustache too. Oh, that's good. Here, I'll show you how nice it looks like when you're stroking your mustache. Looks pretty cool, huh?
pretty funny.
The reason I really wanted to take photos of you is that I really liked you, the blue, and the nice green in the background. Makes for a really beautiful color, huh?
It's a good color.
And it matches your eyes too.
Good camera.
Yeah. Thank you. Good face.
Thanks.
All right.
Thanks, guys.
Still rolling? Yeah, so one of the big tips too is that when you're shooting strangers, simple background is key. So we saw that guy there, great face, great look. What immediately popped out to me was his green outfit and the blue background. And, oh no, sorry, blue outfit and green background. And so that creates a nice contrast between him and the background. And one of the best ways to make better street portraits is to in fact find either somebody in front of a simple background ready, and then the best way to approach strangers is just to immediately go up to them. Just start with compliments. Oh, excuse me, sir. You know, I love your outfit, I love your look. Do you mind if I made a photo of you? Or if you want to be better, you can say, do you mind if I make a portrait of you? Because to take a picture sounds kind of creepy, but to make a portrait sounds much more artistic, it sounds much more engaging, and people are much more willing to be photographed. So once again, when you're out shooting the streets, you could even ask people to move a little bit, say, oh, do you mind a little bit to the left or a little bit to the right? And the more you're able to simplify the background, the more you can capture the soul of your subjects. So, Allegra, what is your name?
Kimchi jjigae?
Oh, do you OG girl?
Yes, I am.
How about, do you got a love for it? Then don't you get?
I do. I love that. And I'm sick, like super sick.
And where's, what's your favorite Korean film?
Ooh, that's really hard. Probably, what is that called? Bad Boy?
Old Boy.
Sorry. Yeah.
And what are you guys doing today, Allegra?
I don't know, Bill. What are we doing today?
I don't know. We're just hanging.
We're friends,
and mm-hmm. I had a shoot today, and she changed her hair.
Every time I get a bad haircut, well, not bad haircut, but like super haircut I don't want, you're usually the first person to shoot
I'm
it.
Usually, and then she's like, okay, it's okay.
Yeah, yeah, and then I'm like, all right, I'll accept it now.
그래서 알레그레 씨, 패션 왜 좋아해요? 패션 왜 좋아하냐고.
What is this?
패션, fashion.
Oh,
패션! 패션 왜 좋아해요? Why do you like fashion?
Why do I like fashion? Why do I like fashion? It's the only thing that's like let me travel because I get paid.
Paid, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Money, money.
돈 좋아해요?
공구?
돈.
돈?
Yeah.
Yeah. 돈 좋아요.
Yeah. So where have you traveled to then?
I've been living in Europe the past like 6 years. So I go between Paris, Milan, Barcelona, London, Amsterdam. I spent some little bit of time in Hamburg this last year. Korea. I was born there.
LFI.
Huh? Oh, LFI. Yeah, oh yeah, LFI, yeah. And let's see, I spent a little bit of time in Tokyo.
Huh?
And I go to Morocco every single year.
Oh, wow. So, what is your big dream in life?
What is my big dream in life? Oh my god. You put me on the spotlight.
Yeah, put me on the spotlight. Yeah.
A big dream in life. Let's see. Okay, I'll actually answer it the same way I answered during an interview for school.
Okay. Where did you go to school?
I went to school in Paris, and then I went to Harvard. So at Harvard, they asked, what do you want to do in 5 years
wow,
or 10 years?
Oh, yeah.
I said I want to be a mom. I think I've told you this before.
Yeah,
I want to be a mom because it's the one thing I won't mess up. Too bad. Yeah.
So. Why a mom?
Why a mom? Well, I can't be a dad. So. Can I?
No, I don't know.
As far as I can tell, there's only...
Or do you have like this passion for like creating a child and essentially empowering it and doing good social justice work? Or like why an entire...
Well, I manage a really huge talent right now. And I feel like super fulfilling when I see them get where they need to get. And I sent over like a couple of American girls who've never traveled outside the country to Paris this summer. And seeing them like kill it there has been like the best.
Dude, the best, you know, girl.
You know, yeah. So I want to give people the same experience I allowed myself to have.
That's super awesome, yeah. Especially because I feel like so many Americans, especially Korean people, like we're so close-minded and we never have the chance to leave.
Yeah.
Wait, where did you grow up?
Oh my god, I grew up everywhere. I don't know where to... Oh, okay, I lived in Korea for like 6 years and then...
In Daegu?
Huh?
In Daegu?
No, why do you say that?
Busan?
No, I'm
Seoul?
Seoul.
Okay.
Do I seem like a beach girl?
Dude, because my family's from Busan and we have this like... Gyeongsangdo Sachuri connection, you know?
I know. Well, I lived in Hawaii for a couple of years.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And then Europe the past 6, so yeah, it's everywhere. It's everywhere.
So what's the next big step?
Oh god. What is my next big step? I want a puppy.
Jindokke?
Yeah, a little dog.
Yeah.
No, but I want a big dog.
Oh, you want a big dog?
Yeah, like half wolf. Yeah.
You're gonna have to feed that dog a lot of kimchi jjigae.
I'll probably do that to the dog. Yeah, but I want a doggy. I have 5 cats already. They're all in Milan.
Are you a crazy cat lady?
I am.
Alright, I'm gonna let you do your shoots.
Ciao.
Do your thingy.
Oh, I'm living on the spotlight.
Yeah, you know I'm still rolling, by the way.
No!
Oh, no!
So, first thing I
want to
do,
I'm gonna
move the stones.
But the good thing is chicken nuggets are actually vegan. Those are not real chicken. It's not real chicken, it's like all soy, right?
I don't know. I don't like chicken nuggets, so I hate chicken.
What's your favorite meat?
try not to eat so much meat anymore, but if I do, I really like salmon. Because I like sushi still.
Do you have to go to Busan for the fish? It's amazing. So good. Did you watch the last Black Panther?
Yeah.
Do you remember the scene where they go to the Busan?
Yeah.
What do you think about the Black Girls Koreans?
It was pretty intense.